And there we go. Just a careful approach, a few casts, and I've got a fish almost straight away. Great start to the day. Great start.
A good start, but let's go back to the beginning. Let's have a close look at five tips that are going to help you catch more fish. So, without further ado, let's get into it.
Once you've been bitten by the fly fishing bug, that excitement never really leaves you. And still, even after 30 years of fishing, I find myself waking up really excited like a kid at Christmas. Often when I arrive at the fishery or the river, wherever I may be fishing on that day, I'll set up as fast as I can, charge down to the water's edge and proceed to thrash the water to a foam. It's really easy to slip into autopilot, especially if you frequent the same fisheries week in, week out. You arrive in the car park, you pick your favourite peg and you walk straight up to the peg and start fishing away. Very often fishing the same tactics and the same flies that worked on your very last visit. We tend to make the same mistakes time after time, and it's regardless of knowledge, experience, or even age. We still do the same things. So, in today's video, what I want to do is take you through five tips that are going to make you a better angler for the coming season of 2022. Tip one then. It may seem like common sense, but preparation is key to having a successful day on the water. Try and pack the car the night before with your tackle. Ensure all your kit is serviceable. Make a little checklist on your phone or a bit of paper. Ensure fly lines are clean and on the reel correctly, and that the drag is set for the type and size of fish you intend to target. Tip number two then, approach. Think back to the introduction of this video, charging up to the water's edge. This is a huge mistake that is made consistently by anglers, whether they are fishing still waters or rivers. A careful and stealthy approach to the water's edge may get you off to a great start to your day. Often, fish can be found in the margins, and if they have not been spooked by your approach, you are in with a chance of catching them. I recall a trip to Manningford last year where I was set up to fish dry flies. And as I approached the water's edge, I could see a number of trout very close into the margins. Because I had been careful with my approach, I was able to successfully target these fish.
Looks like a canny fish.
Yeah, it's a little pointed, eh?
Yeah, decent size. Oh, well done.
Cheers.
So, tip number three, have a plan. Don't just approach the water and think, I'll fish this bit, I'll see how it goes. Have a concise plan in your head. So as you've seen from the start of the video, I started my plan by approaching the water carefully on my knees and fishing very close in. And I was fishing from left to right in an arc. And then what I did, once I'd caught a couple of fish, I knew that the disturbance would have pushed the fish out a little. So I increased my casting distance to up to 20 feet, and again I maintained my catch rate. And then I moved further on by taking more line off the reel and casting further, and still continued to catch fish. Now, if you've got a plan and you stick to it and it's working, it's all great, because plans are great things. But very often or not, plans don't survive contact. So what do you do when the plan's not working? Well, if you've tried all the careful approach and stuff, then it's time for a move. So pick up all your gear, walk to the next peg, and start again from the beginning of the plan. Tip number four then, don't be afraid to ask. When you turn up to the fishery and you go to purchase your day ticket, speak to the bailiff. He's more than likely going to know where the best spots are to start your day. He's also going to be able to tell you what flies to use, what tactics have worked in the previous days. always worth a chat with the bailiff. And certainly here at Manningford, both Fenn and Malcolm are anglers themselves, so they know exactly what you need to know. So make sure you always ask. Also, you might well ask fellow anglers. A lot of them would have turned up before you, they'll have been fishing for an hour or two maybe, and they might have found a successful method. You can give yourself a massive shortcut by simply speaking to them. Most people are dead friendly, and very often they're not. They're more than happy to give you the information that you need to get you started. Number five then, quite a simple one. Be considerate of your fellow anglers. If you're on the hot peg and you're catching plenty of fish, consider moving on. Try somewhere else, you might catch even more fish. But not only that, you may give a beginner or someone new to the sport a chance at catching a few fish from that peg. If someone has plucked up the courage to come up and ask you what you're doing and what fly you're using, be kind, offer them the advice, be open. Tell them what you're doing. Give them a chance to enjoy some success. If you're in a position to give away a couple of flies, that kindness will always be remembered and it may well be paid forward to the next angler that needs a little help. So that's tip five. Always be thoughtful of your fellow angler. Okay, let's round up the five tips that I've given you today. The first tip is preparation. There is nothing worse than losing a fish because you've not checked your lines on the reel correctly, it's tangled up, it's snagged as the fish has run, and it could be that fish of a lifetime. So always make sure that you prep your kit before you go for a day's fishing. Number two then, approach. I've seen it so many times, anglers approaching the water's edge and thrashing the water to a foam before they've even checked out the margins. And as you've seen earlier in the video, there's fish to be caught if you're just careful about the way you approach the water. A plan. A plan's key. If you approach the water just thinking, I'll cast here, I'll cast there, and you don't have a plan how to cover that water, you're going to miss out on fish. If you're methodical and you start close in, gradually working your way out and work from left to right or right to left if that suits you better, have a plan. And you often find that being methodical will help you catch more fish. Information. Information's key. When you hear about lads going on to the likes of Rutland and Grafham and the bigger venues, they go straight to a spot and they catch a load of fish. And generally, they're either on the water a lot or they've been told by the staff at Anglian Water or Bristol Water or whichever water they happen to be at where the fish are. They'll know the likely stocking points and they'll know the techniques and methods to get started. If you turn up to a fishery for the first time, always speak to the staff, and if you can chat on to any of the local anglers, they're generally always willing to help you. And the last tip, consideration. It's a tip not just for fishing, but for life. If you're considerate of other people, they'll be considerate of you. So always try and be kind when you can. And while I talk about kindness, why not give this video a like? Consider subscribing to the channel and hit the bell notification. You'll be told when a new video is going to be released on the channel. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.